Android TVs. I love them and hate them at the same time. Wasted 4 hours of my life, a factory reset of the TV, all because of an Android kernel update that refused to authenticate and connect your TV with Wi-Fi. Make sure you watch this entire video as we will talk about it and you'll learn something from it. The Android TV in question is a Panasonic 32-inch TH32JS600Z. The Z on the end stands for New Zealand. What started this whole issue is an Android kernel update on March 2023. What this update caused is that the TV refused to connect or authenticate with Wi-Fi. Now, this is not Panasonic's fault. After 4 hours of troubleshooting, we found out what the cause is. It is WPA. What it stands for is Wi-Fi Protected Access. It is a security protocol to protect your Wi-Fi network. It provides authentication and data encryption. I will explain more in a moment. What I have tried though is plug in an Ethernet cable into the TV and to see if there was a patch to fix this. There was none. I have rebooted the Wi-Fi router, didn't work. Update the firmware on the router, didn't work. Cold rebooted the TV by unplugging from the wall for 5 minutes, didn't work. Last resort is to do a factory reset on the TV. That didn't work. Now we come back to WPA as I'll explain more. The Wi-Fi router I was using, the security protocol is WPA2 and WPA3 personal. Unfortunately, the Android TV kernel had an issue with that. Before this kernel update, my TV was able to communicate with my Wi-Fi and do an auto negotiation, meaning that it will always choose WPA3 if your device supports it, or TV. If not, fall back to WPA2. Unfortunately, that caused the issue in the TV. I even tried telling the TV to manually accept WPA3, as that's the newest standard you want to stick to, but that didn't work. So the TV could not auto-negotiate with my Wi-Fi router for the security protocol to use. After some experimenting, I found out the TV will work on WPA2. What I have done is by creating a short-term fix, by creating a guest network on the Wi-Fi router at 2.4 gigahertz and set as the security protocol WPA2 personal, and only allow that smart TV to access it and isolate it from the rest of the network. Thanks Android for wasting 4 hours of my time. Please consider becoming a patron so you can help us to continue to provide high quality educational and tutorial content for you. It is also important that you watch this next video as you'll find it educational and helpful to you. Watch it now, click it. Just give it a little click.